Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Quantum Unicorn. In this episode, we are going to pick up where we left off last time. If this is your first time tuning into my show, I want to let you know that all the demos and data files in my program are free to download. You can find these files by clicking the link below the video. And if you are a returning viewer, I hope you have taken my advice and spent some time practicing the code we covered in our last episode. And just a kind reminder, this course is meant for educational purposes only. The data and information presented in this video is not investment advice, okay? And please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and click the bell icon on to receive the latest updates. Thank you. Okay, well, let's get started here. Take a look at those codes. This set of Python code is used to approximate the mean and variance of the log daily return of Apple stock. Apple log return is a pandas series that contains the log daily returns of Apple stock. Mean is a pandas function that calculates the average value of a series. And in this case, it calculates the average value of the log returns of Apple stock. And std dof equals to 1 is a pandas function that calculates the standard deviation of a series. And the parameter dof equals to 1 specifies that the denominator of the variance calculation is m minus 1 instead of m, which is known as Bessel correction and is used to estimate the true population variance from a sample. So, and the calculated mean and variance can be used to estimate the expected value and risk of the log daily return of Apple stock. In finance, the mean and variance of a stock's return are important inputs to portfolio optimization models and risk management strategies. Okay, coming up next. This set of Python codes is used to calculate the probability density function of the log daily return of Apple stock using the mean and variance previously calculated. The PD data frame creates an empty pandas data frame, and the MP arrange creates an array of numbers from a negative 0.1 to positive 0.1 with a step size of 0.001. And the norm PDF, this is a function from the SciPyStats module that calculates the PDF of a normal distribution given a set of x values, a mean and a standard deviation, which is sigma. And the PDF can be used to calculate the probability of losing over 5% in a day by integrating the area under the PDF to the left of negative 0.05. Okay, to the left of negative 0.05. And this represents the probability of the log daily return being less than negative 5%. The probability can be approximated by summing up the PDF values at each x value to the left of negative 0.05 and multiplying by the step size. Okay, great. Okay, next, the Python code PLT Ylin. The PLT ELIN 020 sets the limits of the y-axis for the plot to be from 0 to 20. The second line of code is quite complex. It is used to shade the area under the PDF curve to the left of negative 0.05, which is the probability of losing over 5% in a day. MP arrange creates an array of x values from negative 0.1 to negative 0.01 with a step size of 0.0001. And the norm PDF, this line calculates the PDF of the log daily return for the given range of x values. And the PLT fill between function is used to fill the area between the x-axis and the PDF curve, bounded by the values y1 and y2. y1 represents the PDF values at each x value, while y2 is set to 0 to fill the area between the PDF curve and the x-axis. The face color parameter sets the color of the shaded area, while the alpha parameter sets the transparency of the shade. Oh, by the way, choosing the range of x-axis is a matter of personal preference and also depends on the purpose of the plot. In our case, the values negative 0.1 and negative 0.01 were chosen to define the limits of the x-axis range for the plot. The value 0.0001 represents the interval between each consecutive value in the x-axis range. The fill between function is used to fill the area under the curve between the x values of negative 0.1 and negative 0.01 of the normal probability density function. This represents the probability of a daily log return falling within this range. And the range of negative 0.1 to negative 0.01 covers a 10% range of possible negative daily log returns. The idea behind filling in the area under the normal distribution curve between those two values is to show the probability of a negative return falling within this range, and which can be useful for risk management purpose. Now, if you are feeling tired at this point, which is totally normal, I suggest you pause the video, take a break, and make yourself a cup of coffee, stretch your legs, arms, and vibe to some chill tunes before getting back to the rest of the content. All right, let's get back into it. This code calculates the probability that the stock price of Apple will drop over 5% in a day based on the previously calculated mean and standard deviation of the log daily return. The norm CDF function from the SciPy stats module is used to calculate the cumulative distribution function of a normal distribution. The first assignment the first argument, negative 0.05, is the threshold value for the probability, which is the 5% decrease in stock price. The second argument, MU, is the mean of the log daily return, and the third argument, sigma, is the standard deviation of the log daily return. The calculated probability is stored in the variable prob_return1 and is printed out using the print function. Okay, now let's calculate the probability of dropping over 40% in a year. Yikes, that's scary. All right, so this set of codes calculates the probability of a significant drop in the stock price of Apple over a period of 220 trading days. It first calculates the mean and standard deviation of the log daily return for the 220-day period. Using the annualized mean and standard deviation, it then uses the cumulative distribution function of the normal distribution to calculate the probability of the stock price dropping over 40% in this 220-day period. Okay, let's break into it. The first line of code is calculating the expected return over 220 trading days by multiplying the daily mean return, mu mu, by 220. Sigma 220, this line of code is calculating the standard deviation of returns over 200 trading days by multiplying the daily standard deviation sigma by the square root of 220. And then we print out the values of the expected return and standard deviation calculated in the previous two lines. And the line of code, and this line of code is using the cumulative distribution function from the SciPy stats norm module to calculate the probability of the stock price dropping over 40% in 220 trading days. The CDF takes three arguments: the value at which to evaluate the function, in this case, negative 0.4, which represents a 40% drop, the mean return over 220 days, which is mu 220, and the standard deviation of returns over 220 days, which is sigma 220. And the resulting probability represents the likelihood of experiencing a 40% or greater drop in value over the next 200 trading days. Okay, and the statistical concept used here is the normal distribution, which is commonly used to model stock price movements. The code calculates the probability of a drop in stock price using the CDF of the normal distribution, which represents the probability that a random variable falls below a certain value. The finance theory underlying this code is the efficient market hypothesis, which states the stock prices follow a random walk and that all available information is immediately reflected in the stock price. Based on this theory, stock prices are assumed to follow a normal distribution, with the mean and standard deviation representing the expected return and risk of the stock, respectively. The code uses these parameters to calculate the probability of a significant drop in the stock price based on historic data. Okay, now let's take a look at VAR, value at risk. This code calculates the single day value at risk of the stock price of Apple at a 5% confidence level. Norm PPF is a function from the SciPy stats module that calculates the percent point function of the normal distribution. Here it is used to calculate the z-score corresponding to a 5% tail probability on the left side of the distribution, also known as with 95% confidence. The mu and sigma parameters are the mean and standard deviation of the log daily return of the stock, respectively. The resulting VAR value represents the maximum potential loss that can occur with a 5% probability in a single day. This can be interpreted as the amount of money that an investor would expect to lose, or on average, over a given time horizon, one day in this case, with a given level of confidence, 95% in this case. Okay, coming up next, quantile. Finally, this is our last set of codes. Here, we are calculating the 5% and 95% quantiles of the daily log return of Apple stock. And the norm PPF is a function from the SciPy stats module that calculates the percent point function or quantile function of the normal distribution. The first argument is the probability of interest, which ranges from 0 to 1, and the second and third arguments are the mean and standard deviation of the distribution, respectively. The 5% quantile is the value below which 5% of the daily log returns fall. In other words, there is a 5% chance that the daily log return will be lower than this value. Similarly, the 95% quantile is the value below which 95% of the daily log returns fall. There is a 95% chance that the daily log return will be lower than this value. The quantiles are important in finance because they provide information about the range of possible returns for a given level of risk. For example, an investor who wants to avoid large losses may set a stop loss order at the 5% quantile, which means that they will sell the stock if the daily log return falls below this value. Similarly, an investor who wants to take advantage of market opportunities may set a buy order at the 95% quantile, which means that they will buy the stock if the daily log return rises above this value. Okay, so that's all for today's tutorial, folks. Congratulations! And remember, practice makes perfect. So keep working hard and experimenting with what you have learned. I certainly hope you had a good time listening to me and understood all of it. But if any of the financial theories or statistical concepts we talked about are still a bit of mystery to you, just drop me a comment. I am more than happy to help you out. And speaking of comments, I'm always open to your feedback and suggestions. So if you have got any thoughts on how we can make this show even better, please don't be shy about sharing them. And thanks a lot for your support. Before we sign off, please give this episode a like, subscribe to my channel, hit that notification bell, and share it with anyone you think might dig it. All right, take care. And I will catch you all in the next episode. Goodbye.